Do you know how your calculator calculates square roots? In this video, I will show you the essential idea. Welcome to this, the first university preview. Mathematics does not end at high school, and each week we will try to give you a view of some cool things you might learn about at university. This week, I will give a short introduction to Taylor polynomials. While some other methods are used as well, many calculators use Taylor polynomials when calculating a square root, and also for other functions, such as the sine and exponential function. Let us consider the graph of the function square root of 1 plus x, and look at the point x equals 0.6. That is, we want to calculate the square root of 1.6. A first approximation might be to say that 0.6 is close to 0, and thus the value of our function at x equals 0.6 is approximately equal to the value at x equals 0, which is 1. In essence, we are approximating the graph of the function with a horizontal line at height 1. Can we find a better approximation of the graph near x equals 0? Well, there is of course the tangent line. The tangent line is a straight line which is tangent to the graph at x equals 0. If we draw this line, you see that it is a better approximation to the graph than the horizontal line we drew before. In school, you probably learned how to calculate the equation for the tangent line, and we will review this in week 5. In this case, the tangent line is given by the equation y equals 1 plus x over 2. Plugging x equals 0.6 into this equation, we obtain that square root of 1.6 is approximately 1.3, which is a better approximation of the square root of 1.6 than 1 is. To obtain an even better approximation of our square root, we first realize that 1 plus x over 2 is a polynomial of degree 1. Thus, we can try to approximate our function not with a polynomial of degree 1, but with a polynomial of higher degree instead. Let's start with 2. It turns out there is one polynomial of degree 2 which best approximates square root of 1 plus x near 0. This is called the Taylor polynomial of degree 2. The formula for the tangent line is calculated using the derivative. In fact, the function 1 plus x over 2, giving the tangent, has the same value and derivative as the function square root 1 plus x at x equals 0. The degree 2 Taylor polynomial can be calculated by also insisting that the second derivative of f equals the second derivative of the approximating polynomial. The result is 1 plus x over 2 minus x squared over 8. As you can see, this tracks the graph of square root 1 plus x pretty well. A better approximation for square root 1.6 is thus 1.255. But we are not yet satisfied with our approximation. We want 10 digits to fill up the screen of our calculator. How can we make an even better approximation? Well, we could try approximating a function with a degree 3 polynomial. The best approximation of f with a degree 3 polynomial is the Taylor polynomial of degree 3. And it turns out to be the one on the slide. The approximation of square root 1.6 becomes 1.2685. We made an adjustment of just 0.01, so we might be confident in our first two digits, 1.26. Indeed, in this case the approximation always improves if you use a higher degree polynomial. To get to 10 digits, it turns out we need to calculate the degree 32 Taylor polynomial. This polynomial contains 33 terms, and it might still sound a lot of work to add up 33 numbers. But for a calculator, this is of course no work at all. In particular, we have reduced calculating a square root to simpler operations as multiplication and addition. Most functions you will encounter can be approximated by Taylor polynomials. The advantage of using Taylor polynomials instead of the original function is that polynomials are some of the easiest functions around. Thus, however complicated the problem gets, you can always make it simpler by turning every function in sight into its Taylor polynomial. One question you should ask yourselves whenever you approximated anything is how big the error is. An approximation is only useful if the error is small. So you can ask yourself questions like, how does the error change if I change the degree of the polynomial? How does the error change if I calculate square root of 1.2 instead? Do I also get good approximations for different functions? And of course, the fundamental question, how do I even calculate these Taylor polynomials? At university, you can explore these questions and others.